So yeah, you're responsible for over 80% of my lay count. I was at 10 lays when I first found your stuff. Now I'm over 50. I haven't kept exact track, but it's around there.
What's up, guys? John Anthony here from John Anthony Lifestyle. Decided to do some recordings outside. Here we have the beautiful, picturesque view from the penthouse in Brazil. Instead of recording in the room that has the desk, so everyone says, look, he's recording in a basement. Okay, just the fucking loser red pill coaches say that. If you are not yet a subscriber, please subscribe below. New notifications of videos every single day, all through 2021. And in this video, I want to go over a couple amazing success stories. A lot of the guys that come on my 8-week program, they are ending up with their schedules packed out sooner than they realized was even possible. Usually by week 2 or 3, guys are starting to get 5 to 10 dates a week and packing out usually a date per day or even multiple dates in a day in a lot of cases, and not having time to even go on all the dates, okay? So it's literally like going from one side where guys are like struggling, not knowing where the next girl is going to come from, not knowing even how to get the next girl, to having way too many girls to even deal with them all properly, okay, and even have time to see them all, which is a great place to be in, because then you can be selective and stick with the very high quality ones, you can build out a full rotation, and you can have regular new closes coming in. So we're going to roll those clips, but if you'd like to get very, very good at the game, this is the final week I'm doing those intro calls where I'm taking them personally. After this, it's going to be team members on my team, coaches, that are going to be going through with you how we can help you, okay? To remind one more time, by the way, the link in the description for my personal call schedule link for that free 30-minute call is in the description. But to remind you guys one more time, I teach you the lead acquisition part, how to do everything online, in bars and clubs, and during the daytime. Then that all funnels down into phone numbers. And then I teach you exactly what to text in order to set up public dates and dates straight to the house. Statistically, I can get about 70 to 80% of the girls come straight to the house with my texting scripts. So if you had 10 girls willing to meet up, about half will agree to come over straight away. The other half will object, say they prefer to meet in public, they're not that kind of girl, they don't go over to a stranger's house right away. I have an objection response for that that converts another 2 or 3 out of those 5 objectors. So overall, about 7 or 8 out of 10 will come straight to the house. And then I show you exactly how to close. And then for those 2 or 3 out of the 10 that want to do a date in public for coffee or drinks, I show you the exact game plan for running your date to optimize the chance of bringing the girl home. Okay, and then once you get a close, I show you exactly how to keep the girl around. Okay, so let's take a listen to these two couple stories. Very, very informative and inspiring. And then I will talk to you at the end.
Pretty much like, continue. Yeah, there we go. So yeah, you're responsible for over 80% of my lay count. I was at 10 lays when I first found your stuff. Now I'm over 50. I haven't kept exact track, but it's around there. And
you have Occam's Leeds Machine and Corona Pickup, all three of those.
That's it. I've got Occam's Leeds Machine and Corona. Leeds Machine is probably the most effective one. You already know that, but but yeah, and I just dropped my first Tinder with pro photos like a week ago, and I've had like a new date every day, and in some cases 2 dates like every day for the last week, and I've got like a date set every day for like the next week.
Nice. Yeah, and you said that you had 3 today.
4 back. New closes on the weekend. Okay. 4 new closes on the weekend.
Last weekend?
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
Yeah,
was that a record for you?
Was it a record for me? I think I've done 3 on a Saturday. No, it wasn't a record. I think it's like on par with my best weekend, actually.
Nice.
Yeah.
Like you were telling me before, like, when you're speaking, like you can think back to the time before you found my.
Oh, dude. Oh, yeah, dude. Like, I was so frustrated, like, almost to like the point of giving up. But like, I don't know. I think the video I first clicked on, it was like an infield breakdown. It was like a 5-minute one where you approach that girl on the street.
Yeah.
And you're just like, yeah, look, it's simple. I answered her objections, and that, and then yeah, that's when I stopped following RSD and.
Wait, this was the Victoria's Secret one, or which one?
Oh, no. Okay, okay. She was like that kind of Irish.
Kind of half Asian.
That one, yeah.
In that situation, yeah, she'd already lost her friends, but in that situation, it's just as simple as proposing, hey, we should go have drinks, and then you just answer objections. Yeah, you always want to be trying to move it forward and then answer objections that get in the way. But it's supposed to be like a straight line thing, like Jordan Belfort's straight line persuasion system, where you're moving them from open to close. And then when you hit objections or points of noncompliance, you deal with those in turn and then direct it forward again.
And then just get them back and like, yeah, so let's go. And
what you said about how you're ready to give up and all that, and you're like really frustrated. If you, that's,
oh yeah,
that's what I hear from most guys.
It was so hard for me to land dates. Like I just could not fucking do it for the life of me.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I don't know. I hadn't really tried cold. Like I didn't even want to fuck around with cold approach before I knew like kind of what worked and what didn't, but like online game couldn't make that shit work. Yep. And it's like, I'd always somehow like lose. Like if I happened to get a warm lead by chance, I'd always lose it somehow because like, well, I wasn't moving it forward and I was like trying to impress the girl basically.
Yeah, that's what everyone's doing. And that's RSD's fault largely. RSD was telling everyone to be the fancy guy, the entertaining guy, the, you know, the cool guy, that all these things basically all coming from the wrong frame of trying to present something that you think the girl wants to see rather than just being congruent with your own internal high value self. That's like the huge mistake there. And guys are always just like trying to keep the interaction going without actually trying to move it forward towards any kind of result is the other big
problem.
It's guys will just have
conversations
leading to nowhere.
No, so yeah, so you fix that by basically giving me the like, you know, stick to this, move like the interaction forward strategy, and if it happens not to work, basically it's not your game.
And yeah, like, exactly.
Yeah, well, that's right.
Then your ego is protected. Then your results start coming in, and then like what you said, like with the whole week booked up of dates, that's like the very typical result of most guys I work with. They end up with not enough time to see other girls, too many dates packed into their schedule, and it's nice to be on the other side instead of just sitting there digesting YouTube content that's all theoretical and woo woo and stuff, and still having no clue, which is where most guys are.
Oh, at. God. That's right. You could spend all day like kind of swindling those concepts. Like I was right there. Like and then there's also some guys who are like semi legit, but not quite on your like hyper optimized level. That are just like, oh, you know, just go out because you know the advice is good as like just go out because your probability is zero. Like if you don't approach, which is true. But then there are cases like of those guys' clients that have just been like approaching for ages and haven't gotten shit.
I made a video about why taking action is not like RSD's big mantra was like just take action, but actually it can be detrimental to take massive action implementing a very incorrect or very suboptimal strategy, because for one you're reinforcing all kinds of bad behaviors, and for two
you're negative feedback and your brain's learning that like girls respond negatively to me. Mm-hmm. Therefore, I think I get what you're trying to say.
Yeah, guys would deflate their confidence, and then they're thinking like, okay, I've done like 1,000 approaches, like I still suck. And RSD's message was like, eventually you'll get very good with this approach. But
yeah, with the contrary,
it just make the guys more weird, more frustrated, more hopeless, and more in need of like the next solution, which is the next product or service from RSD. But, you know, the better way is to learn optimal strategy. And then most of my guys start executing within like the first or second week of training and just start getting on the other side very quickly. Because once you're running properly, then you just end up with lots of dates. And then you know how to close your dates, you know how to keep them around. So,
yeah,
that's the much better way. But, yeah, I appreciate it. Thanks for sharing all that. So you went from 10 to 50 and you said you had a girlfriend for a while and that was like, was that like a full package girl to you?
She was pretty full package, like, you know, close to a 10. And and like, you know, for context, like I still live with my parents. So like the fact that I was able to do that is pretty amazing.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, she
was banging her. She was fantastic.
What's that?
You were just hanging out with her at her house, or?
No, my house. I've kind of got my own area down here. Okay. Like, I can bang the chicks, and like it. She doesn't have to interface with anyone.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, but cool. I'm like an apprentice welder / fabricator.
Mm-hmm.
Like that's what I'm. So I've got like a full time job. So yeah, don't have a lot of time to see these girls, but.
But yeah, that's the whole point is to maximize the. utility of the time that you do put in.
Yeah, well, that's right. Like, and it's, you know, it's going pretty well.
Good. Actually, I had kind of a weird thing last night, and I was dying to talk to you about it. Amazingly hot Brazilian chick. Like, she's in like the top three of my lifetime.
Yeah, Brazilian.
And she's from Sao Paulo. Oh my God, man, you are not fucking kidding.
Yeah, they have like, they just have amazing.
It was like kind of like.
Go ahead.
What'd you say?
I just said they have good genetics.
Oh, sorry. Yeah.
A lot of them are.
Yes. And it like her face. Oh my God. Really? Yeah.
So what happened?
Oh, so like I've been trying to chill out a little bit more like before the dates, and I was just on the phone on the call with Isaac, and I was like thinking, all right, this time just shut up and, you know, chill out a little bit. Cause I kind of, you know, goof off too much. I've realized and like, all that stuff, but it just like went perfectly. Like everything went perfectly from start to finish. Like she fucking rocked my world. And I was like, I was so glad I kept. Yes. Yeah.
Oh, nice.
And I was just like, it was like very fast too. Actually, it was, sorry. Yeah.
Is this girl? I know you said you banged. Was like a 9.9 to you the other day. Is it this chick's hotter than that?
Yeah. Nice. Yeah, like I think this chick was like takes the fucking cake, man, because she just was like, I don't know, she was so into me as a man, I guess. I'm not even really like, I can't really exactly verbalize it, but she just treated me like a fucking like a $1 million. The other one was like very like nice and everything, but just like a whole different thing. And she was so sexual, like the Brazilian chick was just like, it was, I didn't really have to do that much actually. Just escalate and shut up. Do you know what I mean?
Yep.
So there was, it like was really, really good. I don't know if you can hear me, but this phone's all screwed up. I'm in a terrible service area. I apologize if so, just, you know, okay, cool. But here's the weird thing, John. So like definitely the best out of every date so far, like 100%. And it actually was like only $60. Like that I spent, which is, it's a terrible thing to really care that much about, but that was like amazing. So, and I want to see her, like, I'm thinking about it today. Like I'm fucking, yeah. So, but here's what happened, man. At the end of the night, she says, are you shy? Like after everything, she was like, are you shy? I was like, shit. I was like, I don't know what she's kind of getting at. And she was like, basically, I like that you were very respectful, but I was just wondering if you're shy. And I was thinking like, I kind of fucking hit the ball out of the park. So I'm not actually sure why I conveyed like some, that weakness that much or something like that. But I could have escalated more.
Some of the hot ones just try to maintain the power and all this shit to like, oh, you're the shy guy. That's so cute. You know, stupid shit like that. I would have just been like, no, why?
Yeah.
But how did you reply?
I was like, oh, I don't know. Am I? I was like, I'm not really sure. I don't know. And I was just kind of like joking around, but she didn't laugh or anything. Just, you know, she actually kind of mocked me a little bit, to be honest. She was like, oh, I don't know. She like, I was like, she's fucking real, like really cool chick. But I was like, you know, smart and everything. And I don't know. She thought my answer was probably like gay or weak or something like that, but it was pretty weird. But it everything ended well. Just maybe that's what it is, but it was I don't know, just a little bit of puzzlement. Actually, can I ask you something else? What do you say when they ask like how many women I know how many women, that answer always stick to like a, you know, moderate number, but what about when they ask when's the last time you had sex? What do you say if you were
I say usually like a month ago. Do you want to make it sound like you never banged chicks, but you don't want to sound like a player either? So I'll say like a few weeks ago or a month ago. And I'll say like I was in a relationship recently, because I bang a lot of these chicks raw because I have a vasectomy and all that shit. So they'll be like, oh, like, you know, are you sleeping with lots of people? And I'll say like, no, I was in a relationship recently. And are you dating lots of people? No. Like, you don't ever want to come across as a player or a guy that fucks lots of chicks. It's like a bad image to them.
Okay. I actually went the opposite way, and she just kind of laughed. She was like looking right through me, dude. Honestly, just she was like, I was like, I don't remember the last time, and she just like laughed, like yeah, whatever. Yeah. So I was like, oh my god. So yeah.
What about did you cut the next plan?
Yeah, just really. Yeah, so we have plans again for Friday, and I really want to keep this girl on the regular, man. Oh my god. But actually, I'm seeing another girl tomorrow night, so it's going to be interesting. She's also a smoke show.
How many of you close? I remember in the beginning, you were like skeptical you were going to be able to pull it off. Now you're getting 9.9s, 10s.
Oh my god, 7 so far since the start of the program. I can't even believe it. And that's with 2 weeks out of the program. Like I was in bed for a week sick, and then I was like, I should have been in bed the next week. I was brain dead and useless. And yeah, it's amazing, man. It's really, really awesome.
Yeah, Brazilian chicks are cool. They have like they're like pretty down to earth, and they're sexy and fun.
Yeah,
that's why that one that you have over the top three or whatever. There's like this is supposed to be one of the hottest girl places in the world in Florianopolis. There's just like chicks, super super hot chicks walking around everywhere. I'm gonna be staying here.
That's awesome. Yeah. I mean, she really like raised the bar. Like too, just the way that she, I was like before, it was kind of wild. Like she kind of treated my heads like in and stuff. I'm like, oh my god, I really fuck. And then she was like, are you shy? I was like, holy shit, what else could I have done here? But I think you might be right, because she's a tough. You can tell she's like a tough person. Like she's a tough cookie in a lot of ways. Like tough personality, strong. Definitely down to earth, but just probably just fucking used to the players or something like that. I don't know.
Yeah. Yeah. If she's that hot.
Yeah. Awesome. I'll let you.
But yeah, don't make sure you don't, it's easy with the really hot ones to like start treating them special, you know, like they're like way worth like way more than all these other girls. It doesn't mean treat them bad, but just treat her like an equal or whatever, you know, like don't get all intimidated by the fact she's super hot.
Oh my God. Yeah, right. Actually, yeah, because I was thinking about that today, because she texted me a cute like couple things, and you know, and I used the lines. I was like, wow, that was so hot. You know, like I use your follow through stuff, and then I was like, She was like, you're sexy, and she's like, I'm sexy. And then she kind of wanted me to go on about how sexy she was, and I realized I'm like, oh shit, I got to get back to work, man. But awesome though, man. I honestly couldn't be happier. It's a game changer.
That's awesome.
Thank you very much. Yeah, man.
Yeah, no worries. Yeah, I'm gonna hit you up for, because you're banging a bunch of stunners and shit and doing packing out your week. I'm gonna hit you up for a testimonial for the channel.
Oh, I'm doing it. Absolutely, 100%.
I like it. It's fucking awesome. Like I had no idea that they actually even did. I had literally no idea that they did that. I took everything at face value. I'm 44 years old, man. I took everything, like almost everything. Every now and then, I'd be like, shit, that girl's crazy.
Well, these girls, the 9.9 and the 10, were those the two hottest girls you banged in your life?
Well, this one may be the hottest. Yes, though this Brazilian chick may be the hottest chick I've banged in my life.
Nice.
Yeah. I've had a good run, though, for sure. I've been lucky. But I'm not going to kid myself. I think this one's definitely the hottest chick.
Yeah, Brazilian chicks are awesome. I'm gonna stay here for a long time.
Oh my god, man, I'm coming down too. Jesus, she was like, I don't even know what's up. I don't even know what she's talking about. Like, what? I haven't seen her be sexy yet. I don't know what the fuck. I don't know what she has planned. I'm looking forward to that. It's so interesting though, John. Too, just like I can't believe like the difference. Actually, the chick last night was awesome. Like, she was like, she's American, wealthy. Beautiful. Actually, they're the same height. They're both 5 foot tall, and they're both blonde. Well, the Brazilian chick, like, you know, bleaches her hair or whatever. Yeah. But it's just kind of a funny, weird thing. But they were both like super cool. But the Brazilian girl, she treats me like a god among men. It's really awesome. Like, it's so funny.
Their culture is awesome. The way they, yeah. Yeah. I mean, I have girls in the house that like literally, like they, I was just telling the guy, I don't know if you joined yet, but I just banged two super hot new ones yesterday, and the chicks in the house just like, They're just all chill about it. They just like go to their room, or they go to watch a movie together or whatever. I'm just like railing these super hot chicks. And then I come down after, like after the girl leaves, and they're like, how was she? How? And I'm like showing them like pictures and shit.
It's awesome, man.
Yeah.
That's like ridiculously awesome. And this is, I can't even believe that this is my life already. I was a sad sack when I first called you, bro. I was like fucking, I was turning into Burger King. I'm like, I'm going to sit here and eat some Burger King. And I was like, you know what? Fuck it. I'm going to do John's thing. Instead, I was like.
Mine closes in how many weeks? 2 weeks off. How many?
Yes. I've had 9 closes now in, let's see. It's really like, holy shit, it's really like 2.5 weeks because I was just not in the game. But if you add up like the, when I wasn't doing anything, if I put like the 2 weeks that I was sick in the first week that I was in, it's like 5.5 weeks. But I literally didn't go out at all. I didn't do anything for 2 weeks because of COVID.
Yep.
I was blasted out. And then the first week, I went on videos though. I'm still on the first week stuff too, like in my head. Like I really gotta dig deeper into everything else. I've done like first, second, and third, but like that first week when you're talking to the guy about how to close back at the house and shit, like that, like it was maybe like one of the third videos or so. That's fucking amazing. I'm not closing at my house, but just using all those lines, like, let me get a little look. Can I get a little peek? You know, yeah. Oh, you know, like, and then push, pull, you know, back off. I do that anyway, but I just wasn't cognizant of it. I can't say I do that anyway. I can't say that. That's not true.
Yeah, I don't actually teach, like, standard push-pull stuff. You're talking about, like, basically micro-calibration, like when you adjust to compliance and non-compliance.
Yes, that's it. Yeah, calibration. Yeah, that's the way. That's what I'm saying. I was thinking push-pull from like the sales world.
Todd, yeah.
But like calibration where you're adjusting moment to moment and just it's really active. So I don't know. But that's pretty much it right now. Yeah, I was, you know, when you had said the other day, I was asking you, I was like, the girl, like, asked me if I was shy and stuff. And you were like, I really didn't know what to make of it. I was kind of just thinking maybe I could have been more aggressive or I could have escalated. I don't want to use the word aggressive, but I could have escalated faster, which I didn't even think was possible because it was the fastest escalation. I just did everything though. I like held hands, you know what I mean? I did everything, like, even if it felt, it didn't feel weird at all actually, but I just did it like much smoother, and there was a lot of attraction there, so that helped. But that was a huge thing. But when you had actually commented and you had said something like, well, you know, that might be just like the girls, like they kind of want to retain some control. And that is 100% this chick's personality, like 100%. It was so funny that you fucking picked up on that. And it was like, I wouldn't have even thought about it, but it's so true, man. It real, that's her personality. She wants to retain the control.
She's making you delete her Tinder. But the thing is though, she's like planning like trips with you back to Brazil and shit. So I think you're good.
Oh, I'm good, man. I'm pretty psyched. Jesus Christ, I'm good. Definitely, I'll go to Brazil with her. We were looking up the tickets. It's only like $600 round trip.
I'm like an hour flight from Sao Paulo. If you end up going to Sao Paulo, you could pop over here too if you want to. I'm in.
Oh my God, man! I would love that. That'd be awesome. I'd do that in a heartbeat.
You're not gonna want to go back to America after that.
Yeah, I can see that, man. This is. There's just a whole different thing. You know, it's funny too. Thinking about that, like on Hinge where I live, like up in the lakes region, there are some nasty beasts too. Even though, but like it's probably on both sides of the thing, but there are just some, I don't know, like, what's wrong with the women. Like, it's like you X out 10 of them and then you get, like, you know, one or two cute ones, and the hot ones are like 1 out of 100, but it's still, it's a very effective dating app though for me. It's I don't know why it works, like, super duper, like, constant matches, people wanting to meet. But it is really interesting. I was thinking about that. I'm like, how you know the stack genetics and what you're talking about with Brazil. Of course, this chick is amazing. Absolutely amazing. Freak show body. You know, like, yeah, I don't even know what I would, I don't even know how I would handle it. You got, I don't even know how I'd handle that much hot pussy around. Yeah. It would definitely go straight to my head, though, for sure, because this is already going to, man. I'm like, wow, I'm the man. This chick thinks I'm the man. I'm the man. This is awesome. You know what I mean?
That's good.
Like, yeah, it's good.
That helps feed everything else. And plus, like, if you have a girl that you consider a 10 into you, like, it makes it way easier with everybody else.
Yeah. Yeah, I think it did make things, like, a lot smoother. I didn't really care that much yesterday, even though I like the girl's absolutely beautiful, the other chick is so beautiful. That was it, like, last night, just absolutely beautiful girl, and cool as shit. Actually, she seems like she is a little bit wilder once you get there. So I'm so curious about how that will go and everything. And I made plans with her for Memorial Day, like, weekend, the other chick.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll see how that goes. But yeah, then I've got a kind of like a chick coming tomorrow to the bar, and then looks like another chick's coming on Sunday, maybe not. The one that's coming tomorrow is like bisexual and she's talking a lot of shit, so I'm really curious about that. And then Monday I have a date. I don't know. It's pretty good. I don't know what's going on Tuesday. I'm already fucking. I'm trying to do family stuff Wednesday. Keep my commitments and everything, and then I'll probably be with this. I might be with this girl again on Tuesday. This Brazilian chick.
Yeah, try to prioritize. Once you guys get like good rotation girls, make sure you like keep things solid with your main rotation girl. Top two, top three, make sure it's basically like your boyfriend, girlfriend without a label, but make sure you like cultivate making the connection good and all that stuff.
Yeah. Yeah. Do like at least once a week.
You kind of have to make them the priority. I had a super hot one that was scheduled to go over tonight and I canceled it because my chick wants to hang out and it's like, whatever, but
yeah,
you gotta do that.
You know what's funny, John? Like, my personality, like, before, I've never had this hot of a chick, for sure, but I've definitely done well, and I've been very blessed, like I said, but with what I did have, which is a very small number, like, a very small number, especially considering, like, my music stuff, and I'm good-looking and been in shape my whole life, but the one thing that was... I would have fucking, like, for this chick, I really like her a lot. I think she's awesome. But if I hadn't really thought about things more strategically, I would be like, head over heels in love with this chick. Spending every fucking cent on her. Like, I don't even know. I don't even know what would happen. But now I'm like, huh, I have, like, the chessboard going in my head with these women. It's like self-preservation, brother. You know what I mean?
Yeah. That's the thing, though. Like, yeah, like, you know, she's falling for you hardcore. You're probably the only dude she's seeing. And then you're seeing a bunch of other hot girls on the side. That's where you want to be. Like,
yeah,
like,
it's very...
You're still able to go bang other hot girls, even though you have, like, a perfect girl for you. And, you know, you can end up cutting off the other ones if the time comes for that. But it's still... It's like you said, it's not like she's like your entire world. And if she was, you'd probably lose her.
Right. Isn't that funny? It's so true. Yeah, that's funny.
Yeah, that's how it works.
Wow, man. Jesus Christ. Couple weeks. Jesus. things have changed. Things haven't changed. Holy shit.
It's awesome.
Thanks, man.
Okay, so as you see, these guys were able to get very high-level results very quickly. Okay, one was able to land his full package girlfriend by around 50 lay count, and I've noticed that by the time a guy works up to about between 50 and 100 lay count, he's capable of getting stunners and full package girls. Okay, at least now and then, it becomes more consistent as your leveling up increases more and more. But then he can drop out of the game, so to speak, for the time being, and see where things go with that full package girl. Okay, and as you see with both of these stories, both guys were totally overloaded. They didn't even have enough time to see all the girls in the day. Okay, so if you want to be a story just like this, keep in mind these guys were in very bad shape game-wise, strategy-wise, before signing on, as almost every single client is that I work with. Okay, and it's a rare exception, unless the guy's not really doing the work or not putting forth the proper amounts of effort, that a guy doesn't get very good very fast. Most guys are going on to do 1 to 2 new lays a week, or 50 to 100 per year, and a lot of them are putting on 1 new rotation girl per week, okay? So do not delay, jump on that free 30-minute call. You can speak with me personally the rest of this week only, and I'm gonna have guys transitioning onto those calls to take those intro calls, okay? You can also book for nights and weekends, okay, starting next week, but I'll put the link to book on nights and weekends below mine, okay, in case you wanna talk to one of the other guys if you only have night or weekend availability, and that's US availability. If you're an international, do the time zone conversion, etc. So thank you so much for watching. I hope this was inspiring. I'm very proud to be running the leading program in the industry. My business model is to So I'm very proud to be running the leading program in the industry, where guys are getting extremely, extremely good very fast. My business model is centered around fixing the problem permanently. Okay, it's if you need coaching after my program, that means I didn't do my fucking job. Okay, so all these assholes that I call out in the industry that are selling you product after product after product, boot camp after boot camp after boot camp, year after year, keeping you on the hamster wheel, okay, just having you there as a paying client year after year, their business model is to never help you. Okay, but only to keep extracting as much money as possible. Okay, and then I come in and actually solve the problem once a guy discovers me and actually decides to move forward with me. Okay, and I hear every day guys say, oh, I went through all the different coaches on YouTube for dating and you're the only one that seems super authentic and that actually really did this stuff and that actually is capable of helping me. That's because I have an optimized, practical, straightforward, easy to assimilate system. Okay, and that's why most guys are getting very good very fast. Okay, and I don't want to keep selling to you for life. I want to fix the problem and fix it permanently, and then you can go and keep executing the system for a lifetime and reaping the rewards either on a daily basis or at a minimum, at least on a weekly basis, for decades and decades. Okay, so do not delay, jump on that free 30-minute call and subscribe below, press the notification bell if you're not yet a subscriber. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you on the next video. Take care. Some do it for the income, but we do it for the outcome. Some of us are active while others just let their mouth run. No doubt, son, this is not just about fun. We will not be outdone by these cowards who shout scum.